his face, and he looked around and said, "I'm lonely. I'll make me a world." And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything, blacker than 100 midnights, down in a cypress swamp. And God smiled, and the light broke, and the darkness rolled up on one side, and the light still shining on the other. God said, "That's good." And God reached out and took the light in his hands. And God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun. And he set that sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered it up in a shining ball and flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with the moon and stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world, and God said, "That's good." And God walked around, and God looked around onto all he had made. He looked at his sun, he looked at his moon, he looked at his little stars, he looked at his world with all its living things. And God said, "I'm lonely still." And God sat down on the side of a hill where he could think. By a deep, wide river he sat with his head in his hands. God thought and thought till he thought, "I'll make me a man." Up from the bed of the river, God scooped the clay. And by the bank of the river, he kneeled him down. And there, the great God Almighty lit the sun and fixed it in the sky, who flung the stars to the most far corner of the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hands. This great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, toiling over a lump of clay, till he shaped it in his own image. And into it, he blew the breath of life. And man became a living soul. Amen. Amen.